All right, this is Barry coming to you from our Glacier Point project out here in Prosper, Texas. It is a Tuesday afternoon, about 4 o'clock. The temperature is about 68 degrees. And as you can see, my goodness, it is one of the prettiest days I've seen in a long, long time. Very, very light breeze blowing. As you can see from that tree right there, the leaves are just slightly moving. So we have got some fantastic weather. I've been out here about an hour. Form crew just left and they've got our foundation ready to pour. We've got it called for an engineer's inspection for tomorrow, Wednesday, and we've got it scheduled for a city inspection for Thursday. If we fail the engineer's inspection Wednesday, tomorrow, for some technical issue, like maybe not having a piece of rebar where it needs to be, there's a piece of rebar right there. Hopefully it's an extra one left over, not one that they forgot to put in. But what'll happen is this engineer will come out with the structural plans from the engineering firm, and he will make sure that every one of these cables is in the right place, every piece of rebar is in the right place, the beams are the proper depth, all the reinforcing has been placed properly. He doesn't care about the forms. If we pour this foundation in the wrong place, he doesn't care. He just wants to make sure that it doesn't come apart. So it's his job to inspect and make sure that the cables and the steel and the beams and the pads and everything are constructed properly. And so if we do happen to fail his inspection for some technicality, we'll have time to get it corrected Thursday morning before the city inspector comes out, and we can still get our city inspection. Our plumber has also been out this afternoon, and when the foundation crew gets done, the plumber has to come out and wrap his pipes. There's a couple of them right there. And what he's done is he's wrapped those pipes in a kind of a styrofoam or a foam rubber type. It's made for that purpose. Pipe wrap. I don't know what the technical name of it is. But it keeps the concrete from coming right up into contact with that pipe and gives it just a little bit of flexibility so that if this foundation moves a little bit, it doesn't break that pipe. And that's another code requirement. Here's one of our piers. As you remember from a previous update, we poured the piers. And what they've done now is they've dug them down to where the tops of the piers are exposed. So when they pour this beam, the concrete from the beam will go all the way down on top of the pier so that all the piers will have beam concrete resting right on top of them. Another thing that our plumber's done is he's put in what's called our tub and shower boxes. These are boxes that will create a leave out in the foundation, an area where there's no concrete, so that he can come back and attach the drain, in this case, the shower, and over here, the tub. And as you can see, that's the way it is all over this slab. And it is now ready to be inspected and then ready to be poured. I'll get a quick shot. I don't know if this shows up in the video or not, but there's a yellow string right here. That string is attached to the top of the form right there. It's stretched taut and it goes all the way across the slab and it attaches to the top of the form right there. And that string allows them, as they're working, to get the depth of these pads right. So the distance from that string to this pad has got to be 4 inches. It can be more than that. Of course, if it is, it's a waste of concrete, but it's got to be 4 inches to meet the engineer's requirements. There's another one of those yellow strings right over there. I don't know if you can see it in this shot or not, but there's another yellow string right there. It's used for the same purpose. So that is our update. We will give you another one tomorrow and let you know what the engineer says, and another one on Thursday letting you know what the city says, and then we'll hopefully pour this thing on Friday. Over and out.